Hey everyone. Welcome back to the Riffsphere channel. Today, we're diving into the exciting realm of Qbittorrent configuration, following the trusted guidance of trash guides. So, let's roll up our sleeves and get to work. First things first, let's open up the Qbittorrent web UI from the Docker tab. If you're using the binhex container, the default username is admin, and the password is adminadmin, all in lowercase. For other containers, make sure to refer to the documentation for the correct login details. It's important to start on the right foot. Now, before we dive into the nitty-gritty, let's change the password for added security. Click on the cog icon, navigate to the web UI section, and update the username and password. Don't forget to scroll down and hit that save button. To confirm that everything's working smoothly, let's go to File and Log Out. You can then log back in using your newly updated credentials. By the way, now would be a perfect time to save the Qbittorrent URL, username, and password to your trusty flat notes. It's always good to have that information handy. Now, let's dive into the real configuration. Click on the cog icon once again, and this time head to the Downloads tab. Set the torrent content layout to original to ensure we keep things true to their original form. Since we don't need to keep the torrent files after they're downloaded, go ahead and check the Delete Torrent Files Afterwards option. It's all about keeping things tidy. Also, enable the pre-allocate disk space for all files feature. This ensures we won't run into space issues as more parts are downloaded, and limits fragmentation, resulting in better performance. However, it's important to note that this feature isn't supported by ZFS, so skip this step if you're using it. Set the default torrent management mode to automatic. This is crucial for our upcoming category folder organization, which we'll be utilizing extensively. When the torrent category or default or save path changes, we want Qbittorrent to automatically relocate the torrent. So, let's check those boxes to keep everything in order. The default save path should be our trusty complete folder. While there's no easy way to browse and select the folder directly, we can use a clever workaround. Simply copy a portion from the Docker template and append complete at the end. Check keep incomplete torrents in and set it to our dedicated incomplete folder. It's all about organizing and managing our downloads efficiently. While we're at it, let's also designate our watch folder as a monitored folder. It's always good to keep an eye on things. Now, let's head over to the connection tab. Set the peer connection protocol to TCP only for optimal peer connections. Now, let's configure the listening port. If you're using private internet access, the script has already taken care of this for you. Otherwise, enter the port assigned by your provider or the one you configured in the Docker settings. This ensures smooth connectivity. Disable UPnP. Remember, it's always best to disable it in your router for enhanced security. Connection limits depend on your system and connection. Starting with the default settings is usually a good idea, and you can tweak them gradually to find your sweet spot. We won't be using any proxy servers. It's best to avoid them for a more direct and secure connection. While IP filtering can be an option to consider for added safety, personal experience has shown some issues with it. So for now, we'll skip it. On the Speed tab, we want to optimize Qbittorrent's performance without overwhelming our entire connection. Let's set the global rate limits to a reasonable percentage of our line speed, leaving room for normal browsing and other activities. You can also set alternative rate limits and schedule them based on your specific needs. This is particularly useful for maintaining a smooth experience while working from home, gaming, or managing data caps at specific times. On the Qbittorrent tab, enable DHT, PEX, and local peer discovery. These features are practically mandatory for public trackers, while private trackers should ignore them. While we allow encryption and even preferred, we won't enforce it to maximize the number of connections and ensure compatibility with various peers. Anonymous mode will stay disabled to avoid potential conflicts with private trackers and maintain optimal speed. Torrent queuing is a personal preference. For now, I'll keep it disabled. But feel free to experiment and find the setting that works best for your download speed. Seeding limits will be completely disabled. Different trackers have different requirements, so we'll let the Star apps handle the fine-tuning. Automatically adding trackers should also be disabled, as it could potentially lead to being banned on private trackers. Let's avoid that. Finally, scroll down to the bottom of the page and hit that save button. Don't forget to add Qbittorrent to Heimdall. Congratulations. Qbittorrent is now correctly configured and ready to rock. Thanks for tuning in. And be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the Riffsphere channel for more exciting content. Stay awesome, everyone.